What's up, everybody? Check it out. Rain World's coming out soon. Woo! Can't wait for Rain World. Today I'm working on secret types. Got some cool new secrets already in the game where you can pretty much build an entire life container. Whoops, I forgot about my chat window. If anybody's chatting right now, I'm sorry, I'm about to go get my chat window. Yeah, so there's secrets where you can like find it in a pillar, but here's one where you find a secret inside some ice. So if you have the ability to make ice, you can reveal this secret here on the overworld. Let me grab my where is it? This one? Plug it in. Get the chat window open. How it should be from the start. Okay, so I'm gonna run. Oh yeah, I'll show you some other ones. Salad Dogs, what's up? Rockin' Bunny Teak. What's up, y'all? These are spoiler. This is a total spoiler alert stream. Right? Stupid. Commercials. Yeah, this is a total spoiler alert stream. Complete. All this whole stream is a spoiler alert. Yes, yeah, I've had a much longer beard than I currently have right now. Hey, what's up, Brandon Dyer? So check this out, there's a secret I know of right here. Boom! Matter Bomb Container! What's up today? Secrets. Lots of secrets. So, I've got all these different new secret types, and I'm gonna play around with how they get propagated through the overworld, but this is pretty good news. You can craft two whole life containers just from items you could find on the overworld. A lot of them are things too that you don't even need special items to find it, so, or to build it. So you don't even need to get ice, you don't even need to get bombs really to find some of these things. As long as you know where to look, you can get a lot of these. Yes. You can pick up bombs without having a bomb container. Where did that happen for you? The game is not meant to do that. So that's a bug. You're supposed to have a bomb. You're supposed to be required to have a bomb container before you ever get a bomb drop. But the saving grace is that the game won't allow you to actually have the bombs unless you have the bomb container. So where did that happen for you, Teak? In the Swordless Dungeon? You found a bomb? Where did you find a bomb? Where did you find a bomb in the Swordless Dungeon? Do you mean you found the bomb container in the Swordless Dungeon? Cause that can happen. That's meant to happen. If you're such a badass that you go into the Swordless Dungeon, you find the secret bombs, which are there, then you've earned the bombs. You're meant to have them. But if you're talking about you're in the Swordless Dungeon and you actually found just a regular bomb, and you didn't have the bomb container, then I guess I understand what you're... So which one are you saying? Arcane, what's up, Arcane? Sorry, my chat window is not on yet. Checking out Rocket Bunny's code. Nice. Cool, you're using SFML now? I'm guessing what that's what that is with the SFs. All right, nice. You got things organized into a struct. You're putting it now into functions. This is nice. Ooh, you got a struct window and a scene. Very cool, Rocket Bunny. Look at you. You're starting to live your dream of making a game engine, and it looks like you're doing quite well so far. I like it. Good job. Good job. I even like your code style that you're using, your indentation style and all that. Teek, if you destroy the pillars in the Swordless Dungeon with the top hat, you get bombs. Oh, there. Oh, you found it in a pillar. Okay, let's go fix that right now. Oh, I get it. I get it. Okay. So let me go to the Swordless Dungeon and I'll find an area with some pillars and we'll do this. Thanks, Teak. Nice. You found a very cool bug to fix. That one would probably work. Here's a good area. What are you doing for controller support? I've been using a library called OIS. Oh no, they're on GitHub now, sorry. Here it is. The old link was on SourceForge, but now they're on GitHub. But yeah, this is a pretty good one. The only problem with this is that it's not totally complete, but it's a really cool cross-platform controller library. They also have mouse and keyboard. I just ignore all that part of the code and just use the just use their controller library. Right, yeah, that's how it should be. It's meant to be if you do happen to collect a bomb somehow and you don't have a bomb container, then yeah, it's meant to be that way. That it automatically clamps your equipment based on your current item. So basically, if you collect bombs, it clamps it. It clamps your number of bombs based on your number of bomb containers. So since you don't have any bomb containers, it's like you collect the bomb, but then you immediately have zero of them. So it doesn't make sense for the game to do that to you. So that's why I want to go fix the situations where you might accidentally find a bomb before the bomb container. It's just here in the pillar. Let's run around this screen and see which one of these pillars might have a bomb in it. That sucks. We didn't find a single one. We found two cactuses over here, though. That's pretty good. Okay, let's look for some other stuff. There was a lot in that other area down there. Maybe here. Come on, we gotta find some bombs somewhere. Wait, let me check out the code. Oh, really? You collected four bombs and then. Oh, really? No. That's by design, Teak. Yeah. As soon as you pick up a bomb container, though, it refills all your bombs. So no matter what, the second you get your first bomb container, you automatically have four bombs. And let's say you're all the way down to like only one bomb, and then you get a second bomb container, you'll immediately have eight. So yeah, that's by design. That's how it's meant to be. Okay, we still gotta find some bombs here to test this out. So let's run around, look for some more. Yeah. Maybe up here. There we go. This bomb. Let's make sure it gets the same bomb each time. No, bomb containers hold four bombs. Yep, four bombs. Cool. Okay, so we got bombs both times. Let's see. Okay, so now I'm going to take away all the bomb containers from the player, so we have no more bombs. Oops. They look good in the fire? Really? I think they look bad in that room. I got some ideas to make the shadows look a lot better. Basically, the problem that I see with the shadows in this room is that when they add together, they make it darker, and that's not how real shadows work. When you have a single shadow and then you add a second shadow, it doesn't make the first shadow darker. They don't shadows don't add up because blocking light is blocking light, right? But you think it's an interesting effect? Oh, that's good to know. Okay, I did not get bombs that time. Damn. Or did I? Did I pick up bombs? I just didn't notice it. I might have picked it up with my top hat. Oh, this kind of sucks without the sword. Actually, shadows do add. How to. If you have multiple light sources. But, well. No, I'm talking about. I'm not. I'm talking about where shadows intersect, though. Because if you. If two shadows. If two light sources. Right? Let's draw this. This is a good thing to get straight. Because I thought it was one way, but if I'm wrong, let's prove me wrong right now. I'd love to be wrong, because this would make it would solve me or stop me from coding a lot of stuff I don't really need to code. Okay, so let's say we have two squarey objects. Here's one squarey object. Here's another squarey object. There's a light source. One shadow is blocking one and one is blocking the other, right? But when they intersect, I'm pretty sure that the shadows don't add. Yes, Rocket Bunny, I'm sure I do not have a good tutorial on a component-based architecture in C++. If I had, I would have used it when I created mine. Which is freely available. I have a C++, you know this, right? There's that my I shared my C++ plus any component system on GitHub, and you can learn from that. But I haven't written an article about it or whatever. Ever notice that when you're in a room with multiple bright lights in it, you see multiple shadows coming from something? Yeah, sure. I know what you mean by multiple shadows, but I'm talking about when sh two shadows intersect. Where the shadows intersect, there is where more light would be occluded. Really? Would it? Let's say we have a light here and we have a light there. Any foo. Do you have the good ECS article you linked like half a year ago for me? Yeah, well, I don't think I've ever really. Oh, wait, yeah, there is one good one. Yeah, here's the one I learned from. I think this one's a pretty good introduction to entity component-based architecture. It's not C++ like Rocket Bunny wants, but it is Objective-C, which is pretty close. What's up, Jonah? Yeah, there you go, Teeks. That's the one I recommended a year ago. How's it going? It's going really good, man. Working on some secret types here. And we're trying to solve a mystery here. We're trying to decide whether shadows can add together and create a darker shadows. So let me get two shadow layers created. One shadow layer will be like this light hits there, and then it just goes down to about there, and then this shadow goes here and goes down to about here or so. So that's about how that shadow would look. Okay, so there's one shadow. Yeah, Wendy looks like definitely. Yeah, he's got some awesome articles. Yeah, on a lot of different game development subjects too. Okay, so let's get the other light that this light would cast. Don't know why I'm drawing a whole diagram about this. This isn't really going to answer the question, is it? So there's that shadow. Let's put that at 50%. Obviously, I've already seen where this is gonna go. You know what I mean? I'm gonna draw two shadows, and of course, they're gonna add together here on my Photoshop drawing because that's just how layers work. But do shadows actually add together where they intersect? Does anyone have an answer for this? Please share. Whoops. So there, that's how this one would look, sort of. And obviously they add together. But see, I'm trying to think that, because if I were a light, if I were a photon of light, that's how I'm thinking of it. So Jonah says in real life, shadows do add up to be darker. Nice. Your laser puzzles are coming together. Cool, T. Cool. Laser puzzles. Right on, man. Awesome. Okay, so we got an example here in this photo. These were overlapping shadows around a pedestal at the De Young Museum. Me just think about it. If I were a photon, right, and I were hitting this. This is what, right? You hit this and you bounce back and you go this way. And you hit here and you bounce back and you go that way. Oh, yeah, of course shadows would add together. Yeah, you got, yeah, totally, totally, totally. Okay, shadows add together because if you've got photons that are, these photons are going this way, right? And then these photons are going this way. This is exactly how photons move. They're like in squiggly lines like this, right? So yeah, you've created some light here. You've created some ambient light, or not ambient light, but direct light coming from this light source. And then you've got some more light coming from this light source. Okay, this makes sense now. This drawing did help. All right. Thanks, drawing. So that's why the shadows add together. Okay, I get it now. I get it. I get it. I get it. Since the shadows are dimmer in areas where other. I'm thinking about it just more about the where the light itself is hitting, because the shadows themselves are not real things, right? The shadow is the absence of photons or whatever. So it makes more sense for me to think of it this way. But yeah, it's the same thing, same way, just to a different way of thinking of it. Okay, so there, this has been established. Save some coding time for sure. So, but the thing is, would they, in this particular scene of this game right here, or of Stormbringer, where would they actually add together to be that dark though? That much contrast? I wonder if they would or wouldn't. Huh. Okay, so the only weapon I can use right here is the blink. Bomb didn't appear. I don't think it appeared at all. Oh man. Let's see. I thought I coded this right anyways in the first place. Add pillar item. Random probability. See, it does require you have a bomb container. No, wait, no. This is if you have a bomb container. Oh, this is a total potential bug right here. I get it. I get it. See, this little bit's right. This little bit of code right here, that's good, right? It requires that you have some bomb containers before a pillar will ever have a bomb. The problem is that if there is a bomb container hidden on that screen, which is probably what happened to Teek. So Teek, this is probably what happened. This is the only way I can explain this. Is that you were on a screen where there was a hidden bomb container and you destroyed a pillar and so it gave you a bomb. So we need to protect this one too. There, okay. What's up, Gutting? Let's just assume they would. That sounds great to like simplify some code. Yeah, right? Yeah, they follow the laws of light in the game. No, the reason the Southern Shadows are that way is because this dungeon is in particular, the Swordless Dungeons have special shadows. They always cast light below you. Right, yeah, it's exactly like you said, the northern side, yeah. There was Teek. Oh, nice, confirmed. All right, thank you, Teek. We just totally confirmed a potential bug fix. This is what we needed right here. This one little bit of code. Basically, if there is a bomb container on the screen, it's gonna make sure an only place bombs if you have a bomb container already. Actually, this was. Oh, yeah. Okay, I remember why I put this bit of code in because I wanted you to be, if you're inside this one place where you first get the bombs, they would always have bombs inside the pillars, but I really didn't need that code anymore, so we're good. We can keep that like that. Right, yeah. So you say the shadows are correct. All right, cool. We'll keep it as it is then. No, I don't need to go ch test it out. This is good. This is good enough. I want to get back to the heart of today's subject is secret items and secret containers. So I'm going back to 000. It's a place with this the Oh, it took away the sword. Make sure we have some bombs too. Oh, we need bomb containers. Why do you start the game without the top hat if the character has the top hat on his head? It's not actually a top hat. The item that you're getting is called the top hat drones. It's just it's a drone. It's a high-tech drone. See, it's called the top hat drone. It's a high-tech drone, right, that you put inside your top hat. So it's not that you're picking up the top hat, it's you're picking up these homing drones. They used to be called homing drones, but it's confusing to people because it's your top hat. So it's just a way of trying to colloquialize these sci-fi drones. Is the Linux version is out? Yes, the Linux version has been out for months. It's all up on Steam. If you have the beta version, just download that. It works on Linux, it works on Mac, it works on Windows. Why is there no data types? What do you mean by that? Why, what do you mean? I'm not understanding your question there, Rock Bunny. Oh, the German translation just says top hat. Oh, okay, so that's a problem with the German translation. All right. Just got to get that fixed then. Cool, so all these are working. I'm gonna start testing these other places where I've got some secrets. So we've got that one. I think I tested this one, but I should test it again, maybe. Yeah, I should test all these again because I'm going through a lot of changes here with these all these different secret types and stuff. So 14, 00. You tried it a while ago and installed the Windows version, even though you click Linux. That's weird. Are you sh well, there is Brandon Dyer, there's no difference between the versions. Every time you install Songbringer, it installs for every platform. So it installs the Windows version, the Mac version, and the Linux version all in one package. And so it doesn't matter what platform you're on, it'll always have all three platforms available for it to play. So I don't know why. Are you sure that it didn't what happened when you clicked play from Steam? You should be just able to go into your Linux. You'll see a Linux folder inside your content, inside your Steam content. You've got this is what Songbringer's folder looks like. It's got an assets folder, Linux, Mac, and Windows. You should just be able to go into your Linux folder and run the Songbringer And if your Steam app is not playing this Linux version, then please write me and let me know about that. It works for me on my Linux Steam, but if it tries to play the Windows version for you on Linux, that'd be really weird. Like, shouldn't it be, for example, typedef unsigned int id? And that's what it already is. That's what it already is. What are you talking about? you talking about the word int being missing? Oh, you are. You're talking about int being missing. Rocket Bunny, you can shorten. You don't need to put int if you put unsigned. Unsigned is short for unsigned int. Jonah reporting a bug. I can't click on the link. Oh. Where did this happen? What world seed is this? I don't need the position at all. I already know how to find this position. I just need the world seed. And I'll put that in the bugs right now. But I'll save this image too, because this might be helpful. Can I somehow change the language back to English? Yes, Teak, you can. There should be an option for that, but yeah, I need to add a language option. But let me show you how to actually do it in your saves file. So in your saves file, all you got to do is go in here, your saves, and add this right here. Add language space space or just language en. You don't even need two spaces. Make sure it's tabbed in. Make sure it's under your settings for your particular platform. So that's all you need, Teak. Just that. Language EN for English. It said that Wine failed to run the file. Right, but Brandon. Okay, so Brandon Dyer, I. It sounds like you have. It sounds like it tried to run the EXE version of Songbringer for you. So what happened? What did you try it? Did you run it from Steam or did you run it from the command? From the command line. Because Brandon Dyer, if you ran it from Steam and it tried to run Wine, that tells me that it tried to run the Windows executable file. And that's really confusing. That's either a bug with Steam or a bug with my setup on Steam. But if you just tried to run it from the command line and you ran the Windows file, and that makes total sense. Letality, what's up? I'm doing really good, man. Really good. World Seed Jonah. Okay, all right, we got it. World Seed Jonah. Cannot get to Zero's Cave. World Jonah. Two H's. Got it. All right. Okay, goo. I got it. I got it. I got it. It's on the list. Shaz Robot. What's up, Shaz Robot? That's cool. I like you have the word Shaz. I use that word a lot. Awesome, man. Thanks for saying that. Appreciate that, Shaz Robot. There would there I'm considering there might be some other way you can, well, you can pre-order the game right now, but anyways, I won't go into too much more on. I got a secret I might share at some point soon. Brandire, how would I test a language file? What do you mean? What? You ran it from Steam? That's crazy, Brandon. Okay, so Brandon, next time you run it, I would really like to check this out. So next time you run it, just go into your content folder. Instead of trying to run it from Steam, just run your Songbringer Linux executable. So just go into your Songbringer Linux folder and then run the Songbringer. If you want to, you can always find that whenever you click on a game in Steam, you can right click on your game and then you click Show local content or something like that. So I would be interested to see if this works for you. So you go, yeah, you go properties, you right click on your game, do properties, and you go local files, and you can go browse local files, and that'll show you where your local files are. And then you should be able to just go in there and run this from manually. So I'd be interested to see if that works for you, if you can run it manually that way. And so I'll add a card right here about running the game. Okay, I think this might be a Steam bug. I hope it's a Steam bug, but it could be just the way I have it set up. It's weird that it works for me on Linux, but I don't have Wine. So that's why. Oh, really? Bad translations. That's a good question, Salad Dongs. If you're running it from, yeah, okay, but you wouldn't. I don't. Yeah, you wouldn't want to run Steam from Wine. Okay, German bugs, German bugs. And what was the other German bug? What were we just talking about? Three things ago. What's the other German bug? Presents. Nice. You're working on processing an Arduino? What's that other German bug? I don't know. I'll keep this for here for a second. The development of Lethality, the development's going great for Songbringer. It's incredible. It's really rewarding and fulfilling to have the game finally. When your game is almost done, you're getting into the last phase. This is definitely in the last like 80% or the last 20% or so of Songbringer. It becomes really, really fulfilling because you do little things that don't take very much time and they generate huge rewards. So that's where Songbringer's at right now. All these little things are generating huge ass rewards. Cool, so that still works. Oh yeah, so you would just Brandon, if you wanted to do that, you just go just like I told Teek there, you would add this setting to your settings. So you go into your saves.txt file and you want to go look for your settings-linux or settings-windows, whatever platform you're on, and you just add this one line. Make sure you've indented the same as your other settings. So if you've got a tab indent, or it does actually doesn't matter tab or spaces, you could do either one. But make sure your indent levels is only one indent level deep, and then just put language S for Spanish. Let's just do Spanish right now. Does we have that already? Don't know if Spanish is in here yet at all. No, not yet. Okay, so yeah, that's what you would do though. You just put your language there. And like I said, I just added a setting or a thing here, the cards, so I can get your language options. So this will be in the menu. Change your language. Oh, where do you put the translated file? Yeah, you just go here. Okay, so you would just go into your Songbringer data folder. So this is go assets, right? So you're back at the regular Songbringer folder, assets, data. And then inside data, you've got a whole bunch of different data files, and you just go down to strings. So you would create a strings-es. Set your language to ES and your saves.txt, and boom, it'll just totally use them all from then on. So that's all you got to do. You need language EN or language ES in your saves, and then strings dash ES in your data. And that's all there is to it. Muchas gracias. Okay, so that secret still works. Let's go try this secret again, 510. I just added a whole bunch of secrets, so I got to test all these again. And I want to add a new secret type today. This is going to be the fire secret. Right on. Is Songbringer ready for translation? No, it's not technically ready for translation. There's still going to be a lot added to these string files. It's basically, if you start translating now, sure, you're going to get, there is a lot of content already. Like, they're not a lot. There's only how many lines? There's 400 lines of dialogue and other stuff to translate so far. But this could grow to twice as much. This could be 800 by the time the game is done. It could be only 600 by the time the game is done. But I'm guessing that it'll be somewhere around there, 600 to 800 lines of dialogue and stuff. So basically, if you start translating now, there's going to be a lot of little things I change. Like I'll go in and sometimes and I'll change like this word, single word zooming to something else. And then you're basically going to have to go, compare a diff of your translation to the newest translation to see what's changed. So basically, it's kind of a lot of technical. It's a lot of little work to do if you're going to translate it more than once. And basically, if you're going to translate it now, you're going to have to translate it more than once, basically. So if I were you and you're translating and you want to just save your work, have to do as little work as possible, then just wait till the game's done. Wait for at least 2 more months. Because I think by 2 more months, I think I'm going to have most of the content for the game done. Not that the game is going to be coming out then, but most of this stuff will be, ready to go in about 2 months or so. All right, Brandon, all right, cool. So I just tested this one again. Didn't I? No. Cool. Okay, so that works. As the next one. 120 already tested. Okay, cool. So these four are the ones that are deeper in the world. These first four are the easier ones to get to. These four are like deeper and more difficult to get to. So these are the most important ones to test. So I'm gonna go test 321, 320. Oh yeah, this is gonna be. Nice. Found a sack. This one right here, this is gonna be a really cool thing for speedrunners to find the sack without having to get bombs. And without having to get any kind of special weapons or anything, you could go find a sack, which is going to be pretty instrumentally important. So that's cool. I love these little shortcuts and things like this for speedrunners, because if you know where the secrets are in Songbringer, you can really, really make progress fast. And what's great is each one of these worlds changes. All the locations of secret items change. Some worlds will be really, really easy to speed run. Some will be more difficult to speed run. Okay, cool. This one worked too. That's great. All these are working fine, it seems. 540. This is a water one, I'm guessing. Nice. What a crazy secret. This is going to be a hard to find secret because, first of all, it's water, which is kind of harder to locate. But second of all, it requires that you have to find ice first. You have to build an ice item. So this particular secret right here isn't going to be something that's going to be super handy, but it could be critical for a speed run, right? If you're a speed runner and maybe this has got some great location for this and you already have ice and it works into your route for a certain run, then this item could be critical. So that's cool. I'm glad that works. Thanks, Teak. I'm hoping all these new additions are really going to help it be even more fun. Like all these secrets really make it fun for me as the maker of this game. I don't know where all these secrets are. And so it's really fun to be surprised by the game. And so that's why I'm really excited to add all these different little surprises. Like the ice secret, the killer secret, all these new, there's, look, I found it right away. Nice. And actually, this is the perfect place to just test out the new type of secret I want to do. I want to do a burning bush secret. So this one had the secret just like in the bush, totally regular. I want to turn this into a burning bush secret, so you need to set this bush on fire for it to emit the item. So we'll come up here, we'll like light this thing on fire, the bush will be all fired up for a second, and then it will emit the item. Okay, so I need to check in my existing code so far. This is this code I wrote earlier before the stream was to make it so you can have secrets inside water, which is your ice secret. You need to turn some water into ice for it to emit. So I'm gonna clean this code up, check it in. What did I change here? Oh yeah, you don't hide an item inside a foe if you have a hidden position. Yep. Okay. Ooh, it's a good thing I put this one flag in there. That works. Not flagged and swordless. This becomes not hidden. Position is valid, right? Because in the swordless, it does its hidden positions already. It doesn't need to check that. So that's good. Jostle items. I made those a little. Just reused a function there. Here we fix that bug with the bomb being emitted from a pillar in the very specific, Teak found a very, very specific bug there. Gosh, this would have been really, really, this is so rare, but that's fixed now. Add a frozen item. This is the code that puts the item inside the water. Let's check over what I wrote. If the hidden type is water, we have a hidden position is valid. It's that position. The hero doesn't have the item. Then we add an item component to it. And that is only called from water. So water gets created. Okay, cool. And then we've also got this ability to add or use the hidden water type if there's water on the screen. Let me make sure I did that right. Place hidden position. This just makes, it starts with an empty vector of hidden types. If there's bushes, it adds bushes. If there's pillars, it adds pillars. If there's no other type so far and there's water, then it adds water. So water is only used in the case where there's no bushes or pillars. And this is automatic. So if an area already has its hidden type set to something specific, then it doesn't try and go and automatically set its hidden type. So this can be overridden, basically. And you only found that bug because I was too dumb to find the room with the lighter, so I destroyed every pillar in the Sword of the Legend with the top hat. Whoa! Man, dude, that's some dedication right there. Did you find any secret paths? Did you find any actual hidden, completely hidden rooms? Okay, now there's four different secret patterns, or eight different secret patterns instead of four, so, and they all mimic the existing patterns that are there, so you don't necessarily know that a certain pattern or whatever has a secret. Sometimes these secret patterns mimic the existing ones. So there's dots 1, 5, rows 2, 6, tree pawn 3, 7, rock pile 4, 8. Cool. Oh yeah, emit item now happens in its own function, so that emit item can be called from the collision system, 0 HP, or the freezing of the water. Tree pawn 3, 7, rock pile 4, 8. You found so much stuff, but not the lighter. Zilton, what's up? You gotta make ghost types immune to normal types. What are you talking about? Tree pawn 3, 7. Yep, rock pile 4, 8. Cool, so no, hopefully no bugs there. There's your 5, 6, 7, 8, water, there's a new hidden type. Here's where our gear system emits the item. All right, and yeah, now it places all the secrets. If it's a life container quarter, or the sack 2, or the cactus 5, or the bomb 12. Those are all the ones that are put inside secret patterns instead of like a bombable location or whatever. Pattern equals secret 01 plus abs of secret item minus life container Q3. It's abs mod. No secret overworld patterns. I think that'll be fine too. Cool. All right, check it in. Secret items in water emit via ice. Yay! All right, so now we're going to do the burning bush. Set this bush on fire. Wait, my seed has a bug? There's a room you can't beat in the first dungeon? So what the goal is right now is to take this bush, and instead of it being just like you can hit it normally, you're gonna have to light it on fire. So you have to use your lighter to set this bush on fire and... Nice, you got a splash screen, huh? Cool, bunny. I think we need a different kind of hidden type here. There's K hidden bush. But we want bush fire, so there's two types of hidden bush types. Wait. Do we even use KNOM hidden types? Can't beat 8 of these brain things together with 3 of the 3-eyed devil things in dungeon 1? What? That That's not right. It shouldn't be that difficult of a room in the first dungeon. How the hell did that happen? I'm not seeing that. I'm definitely not. I did not find any brains, man. How can you know which one it is? You just go to your menu. Go to your, click on your map. So once you're in the game, just go to your map and it says level 1 or level 2 or level 3 or whatever. Okay, so I got a new hidden type for bushes that you could set on fire. I'll be right back. I'm gonna get a drink of water. It's hot today. If you have Minecraft open and go into Songbird, it crashes both games. Yeah, Rocket Bunny, you gotta soak it in, man. When it comes to entity component systems, I was overwhelmed too when I started reading about them. I'm like, ah, they sound hard. But I had to let it soak in for like 3 or 4 nights. I didn't even really understand. This is only a year ago. I'm like, I'm not that great of a coder, you know what I mean? Like, it took me 3 or 4 days to just finally understand what the heck an entity component system really was and how it was put together. So if you're feeling overwhelmed right now, I would just relax. Stop learning about it right now. Let whatever you've learned sink in a bit, and then try again to learn a little bit more about it tomorrow night, and then do it again the next night and the next night, and keep doing it for a while until you finally understand what they are, at least understand them. Wait, Songbird crashes. What? Songbird is just crashing now for you, no matter what? Yeah, you gotta get the save. There's an update for that. It's already been updated. Why hasn't your Steam updated you? You might see worst case scenario. Just go into your Songbringer folder and back up your saves file, right? Just in case, there'd be your saves file right here. Just copy that just in case. But when you delete, you can delete the app from Steam and then reinstall it, and that will guarantee get you the latest version. And when you delete the app from Steam, it should not delete your saves file, so you should be all right. But just back it up just in case. That's the only thing you really need to back up is your saves.txt. And then go delete the app, reinstall it, and you should have the newest version that way. I don't know what the heck, why Steam is not always perfect about doing its updates, but sometimes it is not. Like, for example, Zilton's download got totally corrupted. The first time he downloaded Songbringer, his data was corrupt. So, okay, so on to making this bush light on fire. I'm gonna go create where it creates a bush tile. And the first thing I'm gonna do is add the fire to the entity to see if we can light this thing on fire. Nice! Oh, that worked on the first try! Awesome. So now all I gotta do is make it distinct, right? I wanna make it so the sword or jostling it with other weapons only works. Or the fire only works. The bushes are not blackening because I just did this right now. It'll take some time to make that all happen. Okay, so if I add a jostle item here. Okay, I think this is a case where this is where the hidden type needs to be set manually. So K pattern secret dots is a good one, but also rows. So if the tile type is K tile bush, then the hidden type gets manually set to K hidden bush fire. Same thing with this pattern here, the rose, the tree pond, that's always water. The rock pile is always rocks as well, but these two patterns can possibly be bushes. So if they are bushes, we're going to force these secret patterns to be. Oh, and this needs to be a secret pattern. So and constants is pattern secret pattern. Okay. Maybe the bushes are EU fireproof. Right, good night, Jonah. It still crashes? Oh. Wait, did this just start happening just now? I thought you said, were you playing earlier? Okay, we need more information. Tell me all about why this might be crashing. So the last time you played it was before this update, and now you're playing it now, and it's crashing. You're playing on Windows, right? And tell me exactly what happens, and if you have a screenshot of the crash too, like if it gives you any data, like a little window or whatever. Blah, blah. I thought I fixed that bug. I mean, I tested it on my Windows and my Mac, and everything was fixed. Windows is Windows. So if I do that, I think it shouldn't even have a hidden item yet. Yeah, but it's different from different people. Okay, cool. So there's no more hidden item. This bush. But if we already have our hidden type set by manual, we can go hidden bush fire is also K tile bush. But still, it shouldn't work all the way. Start the game, select my save file. I hear some ambient sounds with the fade to black, and it crashes with the message Zilton stated. It just says Songbringer has crashed. There's no details. It sucks. Okay, let's try this. What if you go into your saves.txt and you add this line right here? Add the line skip menu 1. And you want to make sure and keep that M capitalized. So this capitalization really matters. Wait, is it a brand new save? Is it a brand new save that you just started to create, or is it an existing save? Oh, also, can you send me your saves.txt file right now before anything else changes? Please, please email me your saves.txt so I can try it out on my Windows and hopefully get the same crash and fix it. But so yeah, so please send me your saves.txt and then try this. Try adding this skip menu 1, and this will kind of help debug the situation, right? If you can skip the menu and get into the game, then it's telling me that there's some crash between the menu and the game. And then if that does work and you get in the game like this, I would also like to see if you can save from the game and go back to the menu and see if it still crashes. It was the old one, okay. Which is, no matter what, it should work. I don't know why it would crash for you. Crashies, well, this is great. This is really important to get these fixed. So thanks, Teek. Man, thank you. Thank you so much, really. All this is related to all the new menu code I've written and stuff. It's cool to be able to go in here and you can go to your graphic settings and all of your sound settings and everything from the game. But the downside is for now, there's going to be some little bugs here and there. Like this one. You can start a new game. Okay, even more reason that I need to see your saves.txt file. Okay, so when I bombed this bush, it didn't do anything because... In area creation, it's not adding the jostle item. So, if it's a hidden bush, or bush fire, if it's the bush fire, then we want to add the filter fire. Another bug. If you tab out while intro is played, the music stops to play for the entire following duration of the intro. Oh, yeah. Oh, it doesn't resume the intro. You're talking about the very beginning of your intro, right? Or I mean the very beginning of the game, the very intro. Or are you talking about when you're playing? I think you're talking about the intro. The intro. If you tab out during intro and tab back in, music doesn't resume. Okay, so now you can load your old save. But I backed up the crashing one. Okay, great. Oh, awesome. Great. Okay, so this is really great that we have a something. I think we got to narrow down here. It has something to do with the old save, perhaps. So this is great that you're going to email that to me because I really want to know why an old save would crash. So I'm sure there's something in there that's like, oh, this has been updated or that's been updated. And so, yeah, so thanks to you. Thanks, Teek. I'll take a good look at that on Windows on my system and hopefully it crashes for me. Oh, and so you are in Dungeon 4. Okay. You are in Dungeon 4. That's why you had that harder screen. Okay, this might actually be set up now. Let's see. Oh, Zilton's like, my scene doesn't have a bug. Ah. First of all, let's hit these guys with the regular. Let's hit that now. Oh, it still has the jostliness. We don't want the jostle. Yeah, it's a health flag jostle. So E dot health dot flags. We're gonna take away the jostle flag if we're gonna use the burning bush flags. Yep. You can find Dungeon 1 pretty fast with the biodetector. There's other ways to find Dungeon 1 too. You can follow a certain something. Don't want to give away too much. Cool. Nice. So we're still getting jostle items there, but now we'll try the lighter. All right, cool. So that works, but it doesn't emit the item. Oh, thanks, Teek. Thank you so much. Appreciate that a lot. Oh, it would be pretty cool also if you could send me your new save file too. So, I want to look at the differences between those. So if you just could email me that one too, that'd be awesome. 'Cause then I can look at the difference between your old save file and the new save file, and there might be something just there like, "Oh, it's pretty obvious that there's this new setting or new something." So there's obviously something with K health jostle which emits an item and I'm pretty certain it's like around here. Okay, so we've got some code here to emit an item, and this is, I already wrote a function that emits an item. So I either need to use that, I need to reuse my existing function or create another emit item. Maybe I'll just emit the item from where it gets lit on fire. That would make sense. Hey, what's up, PMC? Where do things get lit on fire again? Oh, here. Yeah, so this should not be happening. Don't think. Nope. Just make sure that's also not getting hit. Also, the UI is like not controllable with a controller. As soon as I say select one of both, it just jumps to the one very top. What? What are you talking about? Select one of both? Which UI are you on? Okay, yeah, it does not get this breakpoint at all. So it's lighting that thing on fire some other place. It's not input system. This is where it's adding fire to all types of fiery things. Maybe, no, it's not there. It might be here. Yeah, there it is. Okay, so here we're going to emit an item. If it has one. Well, I have top, left, right, and down bound to the left stick. Yeah, but where are you? What UI are you on? Where you're getting this problem? Is it every UI? Is it only a certain UI? Yay, that worked. But it didn't like bounce it out. It should emit the item using the bounce code. Super sensitive. Weird. What controller are you using? You might want to go rebind your controls too. Actually, I would try that first. The first thing I would try is like go into your just go reset both your controls for player one and player two. You can actually do that, Zilton. You can bind things to more than one button, but it tries to not allow you to do that. But it is possible. Using an Xbox One? Yeah, try this. Go reset player one controls and reset player two controls, but first reset player one, and it will cause you to rebind. Just try rebinding really quick to see if maybe it's your existing bindings. And you already sent me your saves file, so I can check out your bindings there and maybe if that's the issue. Because I haven't done a lot of work to the bindings lately. There it goes. It still didn't emit like a jump at all. Oh, because it doesn't have any velocity. Oh, and we want to do this only if it's like a... If it's not a container... what? Maybe it needs a little X or Y. Ah, that's what it is. I wonder what this does to the existing pillars in the existing item things in dungeon one. Any of the dungeons? It didn't change a thing? Oh, fuck. Has it always been this way? Is it only the UI? These are two important questions. Has it always been this way? And secondly, is it only the UI that does this? What? Yep. For what? Is that? Yes. Yes, it was. It's always been this way. I did. Yeah, I want these to float a little bit, so I don't want them to be... How do I tell? I guess I'll just set a breakpoint here and... Hopefully it's got the item. It's always been that way. Really? And it's just the UI. Huh. It's always been that way. Is it only your Xbox controller? Do you have any other controllers to try? Sounds like I might need to order an Xbox One controller, if that's what it is. Hopefully it's just the Xbox One controller. What would cause it to do that? I mean, let me just do a quick check here. I'll put in my Xbox controller. Because, to tell you the truth, I've been playing more with my PlayStation controller lately, so maybe there is some kind of weird issue that just got... Well, you said it's always been that way. Okay, but my controller is an Xbox 360 controller, so I'm not sure if this is a good enough test here, but let's just see if there's any kind of new UI bugs or whatever because of... BMC. Yeah, this works fine for me. I mean, I can hold it down to move multiple if I want. But if I want to just, like, all I'm doing here is I'm just going, like, you know. I can get the kind of control I would expect. Right, I can totally navigate. I'm totally using this. I can even use the D-pad. D-pad's fine. So, maybe it's either your Xbox One controller or... something. Oh yeah, okay, so maybe I need to order an Xbox One controller. But nobody else has ever reported this. It's Xbox One controller on Windows. It could be X input issue. Or with that new input API. Oh, they have a newer input API than X input? Why do they always do new APIs? What's wrong with the old API? What do I do about this right now? Order an Xbox One controller, really? This is a... test if the menu... just menu leaps many choices at once. I don't know what to do about that other than buying an Xbox One controller, trying it out. The new MPA, oh, only Windows Store apps? Hopefully. Is it okay if I use and modify some of the code in Entity Foo? Of course you can, Rocket Buddy. That's why it's open source. That's why it's on GitHub. You switch your keyboard into French? I don't think you guys have this problem in America, but it's annoying. I can't do the at button. Oh no, do you speak French too? PMC? I know, direct input, that's what I'm talking about. Why do they need another API for input? They already got direct input and X input. Songbringer has to support both of those already, direct input and X input. Now they're going to add a third one? Right? Man. Hey, what's up, Tiger? Okay, so all I need to do is make it so the... If it's like a bush. Zyger, congratulations! Graduated from high school today. Cool. So here when we emit the item, what would be the determining factor here? Screw it. I'll just keep it like this. If it's small, let's try that. Pedro, what's up, Pedro? Dissertation presentation in 10 hours. Oh, dang, man. It's windows.gaming.input. Now we got direct input, X input, and windows.gaming.input. Thanks, Microsoft. Three APIs for the same thing. Stoked to support all of them because of you guys. Yeah, this will work, right? These things are just floating there. It's about the same place. Okay, let's go back to. You don't speak French? It's mandatory to learn some, though. Oh. Do you know the Cave of Ordeals in Zelda? Which Zelda is that? And what is the I don't know about the Cave of Ordeals. What is the Cave of Ordeals? Which one is this? Oh, is this Oh, is this Twilight Princess? I haven't played Twilight Princess. I haven't played any of the newer Zeldas. And I stopped liking the Zelda when it became so 3D. I mean, I like some of the 3D Zeldas, but the latest ones I just really haven't appealed to me. And I don't have a Nintendo, so. But what's it like? What is this thing? Why would you want it? Apparently the Windows drivers for the Xbox One Mac to X input. This is why I don't know why it would be giving them such weird results. Rocket Bunny, why is that inside an enum? It's so that you can define it for the class without doing a static member. So if you have Try this, Rocket Bunny. Try this right now so you understand. So try and define something in a struct that's a constant, right? So I want a struct type s, and I want a constant value, right? Let's try this. Try this const int something equals one. Oh, for some reason that works. Hold on. No, that's not it. How do you get that error? I don't remember. I don't remember right now, Rocket Bunny, exactly how to get this certain error or whatever, but in the past, I've not been able to create con. Somebody can help me out here. And you can't create constants in certain situations for a structure or a class. But enums work fine. Basically, I'm getting around having to do this. Static int blah 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 equals one to create a publicly available. So there, that doesn't work. I don't know. I can't explain it right now. Too many things going on. You gotta go, Pedro? All right, Pedro. See you, man. Good luck with your presentation. Sleep well, man. It's basically a dungeon, but each level has different monsters that progressively get harder. It basically includes all the enemies in the game besides the bosses. Oh, yeah. It's kind of like an enemy run. Yeah, if I have time, I'd love to do something like that for Songbringer. I believe Windows gaming input is explicitly for. Oh, yeah. So it shouldn't apply to Songbringer. Yeah, right. Their whole sandbox crazy, like. Basically, it's their version of the App Store, sort of, but they're trying to do it for Windows apps too. Yeah. Yes, there's so many birds, PMC. We got like a freaking bird paradise out here. It's because we live in this place where I live has all these trees, so like there's so many birds all the time, and they are loud as hell. Okay, so back to this. Forget where I was, what I was doing. Oh yeah, okay. The burning bush. Wizard Fu lives in Bird Vena? Okay, so I should be able to hit this bush and a cactus comes out, but I shouldn't be able to hit this bush. Cool. But if I hit it with the fire. Yeah! This one I can't light on fire. Don't know if that's right. I think you should be able to light anything on fire. If it's a bush and it. If, yeah. Okay, so I want all bushes to be able to be lit on fire. The question is, if I hit one bush. Well, hold on. Oh, Birdvana, like Nirvana. Yes, yeah. State of being. From what I understand too, same thing. Create bush. Let's make sure all these bushes can be lit on fire. E dot collision dot mask. A filter fire. Okay, let's see what happens. Oh, I get the reference now too. Oh, okay. I get it. Okay, so there's still nothing going on where I could, where like I'm turning the bushes black or anything. I'd like to do that, but actually we could do that really quick. But first, I want to see what happens if I light multiple bushes on that are in a row like these. If I light this one on fire, does it light others on fire? No, good. Okay, that's good. I didn't really want it to light other things on fire. But let's see what happens if I have the fiery top hat. Paradise. Oh, the BC Warrior? You wanted to start one? We haven't had a good BC Warrior train in a while. Thank you. This is actually really cool, being able to light everything on fire like this. Alright, let's make them turn black or something. Nice, we got four in a row! Okay, so I'm making bushes be able to be lit on fire. Bush tiny. And trees. Where are you, tree? Tree, there's no tree? Okay, now let's make them turn black. Hey, professional novice, Henko. What's up, y'all? So right now there's some code where it does the jostly thing. But it's in, health system. Here it is. Create some fire. That tile does not look right. Yeah, it doesn't. That's a bug. Okay, so I'm gonna try and take this, the current thing that's getting lit on fire, and just making it black. Its color get set again somewhere else, but let's see what happens if it works. And then otherwise I could probably just add a burnt like render flag so that the render system always knows to make something dark if it's burnt. And then I guess it would need like a burnable flag or something. Like this thing can be lit on fire. Or no, can be burnt. I don't know. Render.sprite, set color. Maybe it just works with the color. Set it all the way to black. All right, we use apply tone actually. So we're going to apply a tone to white. So it's almost black. Those things kept getting lit on fire more and more. A bit, maybe a bit too black. Yeah, it definitely added a lot of fire there. Like, multiple different fire entities got hit. So this thing needs to remove its fire flag for a minute. So invincible to fire for a moment. Yeah, there definitely should be some delay too. I think it'd be best if it got black over time too. So after a moment, it's like it's sort of black, and then after a little bit more, it's even more black, and then finally after like a second or whatever, it's full black or close to full black or whatever. That would definitely help there. But I'm concerned about this whole thing where it's like it's igniting a lot of different fire entities all in the same thing. So if I take away the fire flag, and then give it back after a bit. So we'll say after 1 second or so. Okay, so there we're removing the filter flag or filter fire, so it can't be hit by, it's invincible to fire for a minute, for a second, technically 1 second. Thank you. That's better. Nah, there's only one fire now. This is like a permanent fire entity. This fire entity will not go away. Weird. It's the permafire. Okay, so I'm now going to make it get darker over time. It appears that the regular just setting the color is working, which means that there's basically nothing else that's trying to set the color for this entity. So I'm going to assume for now that I can just run an action on this sprite and have it tint towards a darker, just to get darker over a moment. It was made of Duraflame logs. Yeah, that explains everything. No, I don't need to ease. Let's just tint to. Tint to. Wait, Cocos 2D. Tint to create. Over it. Let's try a second at first. And we'll tint towards this darker version of white. I was just waiting there for a second. I'm like, why isn't it going? But it didn't. I didn't even click the go button. Not bad. Maybe over 2 seconds or so. And also checking if the sprite is already white to start with. PvP Kaif, what's up, man? The game will sell once it's done and it's released. It will sell for about $16. So this is requiring that the color is already white. So I can't do this more than once. Yeah, that's not bad. I like it. Maybe it should go like a little bit less darkness total. So I'm gonna go like a tenth lighter. It's kind of nice that it does it over 2 seconds now, too. That was a nicer transition. And, oh yeah, this delay, too, should also be like at least 2 seconds where it's invincible to fire. Thing that's happening is that the fire is not quite Its light entity is not quite in the right place. Oh my god, my computer is working hard right now. What's up, computer? Why are you doing this? Why are you so fanny? Game show. Game show's behaving itself. It must just be a hot day. Oh, it already has plus one. Let's add a plus 0.5. Ah, still, this fire is getting put right behind stuff sometimes. What if it's one? Still, what about two? Why is it doing this? God damn, what does it need to get above that one? Three? Oh, there, three, it's barely flickering on and off. Four. There we go. It's kind of weird seeing the bushes just like they are. Like maybe they need to turn, you know, they need to like burn up and turn into like a burnt entity more than just being black. But for now, I think this is all right. It's better than nothing. Okay, so mid plus four. I wonder why it's requiring mid plus a whole four for this bush. Like, what does the bush have that puts it? See, the bush doesn't even have any. That's so weird. I don't get it. Or is it the bush tiny? Oh, the bush tiny has an anchor offset of four. Oh, but that doesn't matter. I don't know why I needed to put like that there, but oh well. At least this whole system works. So this is pretty cool. There's a lot of new secret types in Songbringer. You can find secrets in pillars by destroying them. You can find secrets in water by freezing ice. You can find secrets by using your fiery items. Like I just found this quarter demon's tooth here. There's secrets in the walls. You can sometimes blow up walls and find holes and caves and stuff. There's a lot of secrets. One of the next secrets I want to create is like a where you can walk through bushes. So on the overworld, you can already do this in the Swordless dungeon, where if you have an area that's just like all bushy, like this one here, it's all bushy, sometimes you'll be able to walk into these bushes and walk to a secret area. So that's probably the next thing I'll do tonight, is to create, and it'll be totally secret areas. So there'll be some areas of the overworld that'll be totally blocked in. The only way to get there is through a secret path. So I'm thinking maybe there's like up to four different totally secret rooms. There's 128 rooms on the overworld always. And so maybe four of them would be totally secret rooms. You got to find some secret path to get into it. It's not a room, it's just an area of the overworld. So it's outdoors, it's not really... Room's kind of a bad name, but still, the thing is that it would be a totally blocked off room. There, all the walls around it would appear to be white blocked off walls, and you would have to find, you have just like, you know, work your magic, find the secret. This is cool being able to light stuff on so much on fire right now. Have the trees got, yeah, oh, the trees get lit on fire, but not their leaves. That kind of makes sense because the fire's down below. Hey, I'm like, that worked out pretty well. And if I go off the screen and come back, everything resets as far as it getting being lit on fire. Which I guess I could make it so it remembers if something was lit on fire. The fire sword would be a lot more easy to test all this stuff. So if I have the fire sword instead of the ice sword. Oh no, the fire sword does stop when it hits something. Okay, so the top hat was actually easier. Right, so that's gonna be it for today's stream. I'm gonna go get some dinner and stuff. We're gonna have some pizza tonight. Pizza dinner. Woo! And then yeah, I'm gonna work more on these secret types tonight. So there's even a secret right here on the screen. Yeah, there's a demon's tooth right there. It's good to know where all the secrets are. I've been playing this world so much. So yeah, I hope you guys all have a great night, and we'll catch you all next time. Appreciate you all. Enjoy yourselves.